I am Rafiq Islam. I'm the Executive Director for Bioanalytical Services at Celerion. I have been with the company for over 7 years. At Celerion, one of our key goals is to help our client translate science to medicine. And the biomarkers played a key role in this process. Biomarkers have the potential to reduce the drug development time and the cost significantly by reducing the clinical endpoint time. So Celerion has two state-of-the-art laboratories equipped with cutting-edge technologies. One of the lab is located in Lincoln, Nebraska, where I am located. And we have another lab located in Zurich, Switzerland. In terms of technology, we utilize mass spectrometry, ligand binding technology for such as ELISA and mesoscale discovery. We also recently acquired an ultra-sensitive technology, Quanterix. We also utilize qPCR for gene expression analysis, and also flow cytometry and the ELISpot for the cellular biomarkers. So flow cytometry is a very powerful tool. We can utilize the flow cytometry to measure the cellular biomarkers. We can evaluate multi-parameters for a specific cell, one cell at a time. It plays a key role in understanding the immune responses and the profiling the immune response in response to a drug. In terms of disadvantages, one of the key disadvantages is that still there is no regulatory guidance for the validation of flow cytometry methods. In addition, the stability is always a challenge. So at Celerion, we have done some innovative work to stabilize the flow cytometry samples. We also have our flow cytometry lab co-located with the clinic so that we can analyze the samples near real time, avoiding any stability issues. So 2018 FDA guidance is pretty unique compared to other guidelines. This is the first time FDA included biomarker within the scope of the guidance document. The guidance states that if you are using the biomarker for regulatory decision making, the method should be fully validated. It also allows for fit for purpose approach into method validation. At Celerion, we have implemented a three-tier method validation approach, which is in compliant with this new guidance. Celerion has an extensive experience with biomarker validation, and we are well equipped to, you know, deliver our client quality data in a regulated manner. Personally, in 5 to 10 years, I would like to see an robust ultra-sensitive technology for the detection of proteins. We are also seeing some exciting innovation in the area of flow cytometry and the mass spectrometry. And in some cases, we are seeing technology where the mass spectrometry technology is combined with flow cytometry. So the impact of those technologies will be significant in the biomarker research. In addition, we will see more and more microarray technology combined with artificial intelligence and the machine learning algorithm for data analysis. But they have a significant impact in research, but their impact in regulated environment is still remain to be seen.